everyone. Let us start two more questions for better understanding. So I hope you watched my previous video. Okay. Now we come to the exercise 3.3, 7.3. So we are going to do two more questions. Okay. What is that question number 2? In the question number 2, triangle ABC is given. It is an isosceles triangle. So what is it? Isosceles triangle, the sides are equal. Is given. Okay, what is the meaning of isosceles triangle? AB equal to AC is given. Okay, and then AD is perpendicular to BC. That means this is 90 degree. These two are given points. You have to prove AD bisects BC. This line bisects BC. That meaning is, suppose it is D. AD bisects BC means this length should be equal. BD equal to DC, you have to prove. Okay, this point AD bisect BC implies you have to prove, that is to prove BD equal to DC. So as usual, we are using the congruence rule and we can prove. Okay, I am considering these two triangles ABD and ADC, these two triangles. Okay, so what are the 3 points equal here? One point is already given, AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC given, it's an isosceles triangle. Second, AD is common. And then one more, what is it equal here? One of the angle is 90. This is 90, therefore automatically this will be 90 because of linear path. Okay, angle D, that is ADB equal to ADC is 90 degree. So side one angle is that. So what is that? SAS or RHS rule, which is apt for this one? This is an RHS rule. Why it is an RHS rule? Because hypotenuses are equal and then one of the angle and one of the side is equal. Therefore, by using RHS rule, these two triangles are congruent. ABD congruent to ABC. Okay, and then these two are congruence. Okay, once we proved congruence means AD bisects BC, automatically this length will be equal by using the corresponding parts of congruence triangle CPCT. Okay, and then you need to prove AD bisect the angle A, these two angles bisect the angle A. So already we proved these two triangles are congruent, so it can be overlapped with one of each other. ADB overlapped ADC, therefore automatically the angle will be equal. Which angle? Angle BAD equal to DAC. Okay, therefore that is the meaning is AD bisect the angle A. Okay, next come to the question number 4. The question is given, it is a triangle ABC. Okay, altitudes are given, BE, CF are altitudes. Okay, what we need to prove, it is an isosceles triangle, you have to prove. Okay, isosceles triangle, this is given, it is an equal length, that's what I'm saying, equal altitudes BE and CF. Okay, you need to prove the triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. There are two ways for proving the isosceles triangle. One, you can prove AB equal to AC, the lengths are equal, or base angles are equal. Base angle equal we proved means, that is the, we can prove isosceles triangle, this should be equal. So angle B equal to angle C, if we proved angle B equal to angle C means, it automatically mentioned that it is an isosceles triangle. So first I am considering the triangle BCE, this triangle. This triangle includes the whole angle C, that's why I am taking this triangle BCE, triangle BCE. Next, I am taking the triangle, this one, CFB, CFB, this triangle, whole triangle. This triangle angle, consider the whole angle B. Okay, so BCE, BCE considers whole angle C, and CBF, CBF, these two triangles we are considering. We are going to prove this is a congruence. Okay, once we prove congruence, means the angle will be equal. Angle equal means this is an isosceles triangle. The sides will be equal. AB equal to AC. Okay. So it is an altitude. So it consists 90 degree. This is 90. Okay. So I am drawing separately. So this one BCF. BCF and BCE. So altitudes are equal, CF and BE, these two are equal, and 90 degree, this one is 90 degree, okay, and then base is common, so 90 degree, opposite side is an hypotenuse, therefore RHS rule we are going to use here, because of RHS rule it is an congruence. Why it is an RHS rule? One angle is 90 degree, opposite side represent the hypotenuse, BC is equal, and then side, one of the side, any one of the side, CF equal to BE. Okay, three steps, R means 90 degree, CFB and CEB, both are 90 degree. Okay, and then H, hypotenuse, BC equal to BC, common. Yes, side, one of the side, CF equal to CE, sorry. So RHS rule we are used here. RHS rule, we proved it is a congruence. So once we proved congruence means the angle will be equal. So one triangle overlap with each other, angle B and C are equal. Here B and C are equal, that is base angles equal. This is the converse part of isosceles triangle. Side angle, side equal means automatically angle will be equal. If angles are equal means side will be equal. So sides are equal. That is AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC. Therefore it is an isosceles triangle. That we can write from after the confirmation of angles, we can directly we can write ABC is an isosceles triangle. From this we can write ABC is an isosceles triangle. So I hope it clear.